Good day to all of you. As you all know, on the first day of the week, you learn something new, and on the following day, you revise the same. Let us now revise what we learned in the previous class. Can you tell why do we use impress in open office? Using impress, you can add pictures and text to make it more impressive and show it to others. Can you tell why we use line and filling toolbar? Using line and filling toolbar, you can format your picture and drawing. For example, you can change the color of a line, fill in a drawing with colors, etc. Can you tell what is slide bar or slide pane and why do we use it? In the slide bar or slide pane, you can see all your slides on which you are working. Can you tell what is slide layout and why is it used? Slide layout provides different possible layouts for our slides, which you can use as per your requirement. Can you tell what is the difference between slide pane and slide layout? Using the slide pane, you can come to know how many slides you have taken for your presentation. If you want to go from one slide to another, you can do so with the help of the slide pane. Also, you can open a new slide from the slide pane. And using this, you can delete a slide or design a slide. Using the slide layout, you can change the layout of your presentation. Here, by layout, we mean the design of the slide, meaning how you want the slide to appear. The slide pane only tells you about the total slides and you can use them. However, using the slide layout, you can change the design of the slides, meaning that you can change its layout. Can you tell why do we use text tool in Impress? In Impress, you can type using the text tool. Now, all of you switch on your computer and open the Impress file using the method taught to you. If you face a problem, then watch the video carefully and learn from it. With the help of this video, we will now learn how to open our Impress file using the stepwise method. For this, you need to first take your pointer to the start button, which is on the left lower side of your screen. Left click on that with your mouse or touchpad and then click on the all programs option. As is being shown in the video, when you click there, all the programs appear in a box. Look for Open Office 4.1.1. You can scroll up and down. And when you find this Open Office, left click on that. And you will see many options within the Open Office opening up. Since we want to open the Impress file, click on the Impress option and a box opens. Since we want a blank presentation, we will click on Empty Presentation and click on the Create button and you will see that your Impress file opens. And now, let's know what we are going to learn today. Today, you will make four slides. In the first slide, you will type about yourself. In the second slide, you will type about your school. In the third slide, you will make a drawing. And in the fourth slide, you will make a picture similar to the one shown to you. Note that the first two slides should be in title layout and the other two slides should be in blank layout, because for drawings you need blank slides. Now all of you should select the title slide from the slide layout and then write 5 lines about yourself in this slide. If you face any problems, watch the video and learn from it. With the help of this video, let us now see how we will take a title layout slide and type about ourselves. So, as is shown in the video, to take the title layout slide, we have to click on the title layout slide in the slide layout, and where it says type title, click there with your left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and you can type a title like we are typing about myself, since this slide is about myself. Next, take the cursor to where it says click here to add text and click there and start typing using the keyboard. You can type your name. My name is, for example, we are typing Rohit. Then when we want to go to the next line, we press enter from the keyboard. We come to the new line. Now let's type another line. I am in class 5. Or I am in 5th class. Put a full stop at the end of the line. And then again, press the enter button on the keyboard to come to the new line. Now we type the 3rd line. As is being shown in the video to you, I study at, and we can type your school name or you can type computer shiksha. So I study at computer shiksha. Then again put a full stop, and to go to the new line, press enter. Let's type the 4th line here. I am 10 years old. So you can type about your age, you can type about your hobbies, you can type in which class you are, about your school. Again, at the end of the 4th line, we press enter to come to the new line and type the 5th line. I like to play cricket. So this is how you can type about yourself in a slide layout, title slide layout. Have you all been able to type about yourself? If not, please watch the video again and learn. Now, all of you show how you will bring up a new slide. Can you tell how you will bring up the new slide? If you right click in the slide pane and click the option for a new slide will be brought up. Now, go ahead and type about your school in this slide. Have you all typed something about your school? Now, all of you bring up the 3rd slide and show how you will make it a blank slide. Have you all been able to bring up a new slide? Now, using the drawing toolbar, we will make a drawing. For making a drawing, we need a blank slide. You will notice that when we bring up a new slide, it appears in the title slide. Do you know why this happened? This happened because prior to working on this slide, you were using the title slide. When you are working in a particular layout and then you bring up a new slide, then the new slide will be brought up in the same layout. Now, go to the slide layout and select a blank slide. This will cause your new slide to appear as a blank slide. Next, look at the pictures being shown to you and tell if you will be able to make them or not. If you cannot make the pictures, then learn from the video how these are to be made. With the help of this video, we will now see how we can insert a new blank slide and then draw a picture in it. So to insert a new blank slide, we first, when we click there, we choose new slide and we get a new slide. Since we were using the title slide, that's why the title slide comes. From the layout, click on the blank slide and your slide becomes blank. Now, to draw in this, we go to the drawing toolbar and click on the smiley option. And now, left click of the mouse or the touchpad, drag on our slide and we see that a smiley is formed in our slide. If you click on with your left button on these dots, you can resize the drawing of the smiley as is being shown in the video to you. So each of these dots, if you click on that, you see those two arrows and then you can drag on the sides of these arrows to resize. If you click on the side, the dots disappear. If you want to reselect this drawing to work on it, you left click on the drawing once and it gets selected again. Now we want to change the outline by clicking here. We can choose any of these outlines and that gets applied to our smiley. Let us now change the width of the outline. So if you click on the up arrow, it increases, the width increases. If you click on the down arrow, the width decreases. So this is how you can change the width of the line. And you will see the changes happening on the right side of the slide also in the text toolbar. Now look for the color of this outline. You can change the color like we did. We selected the yellow from the drop down window. And to fill in the color in the smiley, you can choose come here and then first choose whether you want gradient color or what kind of different colors you want. And from this drop down, you see number of color options are available. You can scroll the scroll bar up and down and you will see that many other colors are available. Choose the one which you like. And once you click, left click on that color which you like, you will see that it gets filled up in your drawing. So this is how you can bring up a blank slide, insert it in your slides presentation and make a drawing. The different options that we have used are also shown on the right side in the text toolbar. Now, once again, show how you will bring up a new slide. Next, go ahead and make this drawing by yourself after looking at the drawing being shown to you. If you face a problem, then watch the video and learn from it. Again, we have to insert a new slide and draw the picture which has been shown to us. Right click in the slide pane. So click on the slide pane, the last slide, and click the option of new slide. So you will see that a new slide comes, and since we were using a blank slide, this time a blank slide comes up. Now from the drawing toolbar, look at the basic shapes, click there and then choose the cube because we have to draw a cube and drag in the slide. So you will see that your basic structure, the basic cube is made. Let us now change the outline again by going here to the drawing and filling toolbar and choosing the boundary line that we want. Now to change the width of the boundary line, we click on the up arrow so that we are going to increase the width of the boundary line like this, as is being shown in the video. And next, we change the color of the boundary line. So we can select the color which we like. For instance, we like green. We can click on that and it changes in our slide. Next, for the fill-in color, let's select this time the bitmap style. And from this drop-down, let's click the one which has those bricks in it, or the brownstone. So this way, you can get the blank slide and make the drawing which was being shown to you. We will end today's class here. So you go ahead and close your Impress file. If you face a problem, watch the video and learn from it. This video will teach us how we will close our Impress file. So to close, firstly take your cursor to the top right corner of the screen where you see a cross sign or a X sign and left click on that. Once you click there, a box appears with three options: save, discard, which means don't save, and cancel. So since we do not have to save this file, we will click on discard and your file gets closed. Now, go ahead and properly shut down your computers. Today, you practiced with the text tool and drawing toolbar. Thank you.